Introduction to Presocratic philosophy. In this video, I will talk about the general historical and philosophical characteristics of Presocratic philosophy. That includes where and when did those philosophers live, what were the principal schools of thought in that era, what were the fundamental concepts of their philosophy, how are their teachings preserved, and how do we cite the fragments of Presocratic thinkers. There is something primal and innocent to their thought, very much different from what philosophy looks like today. Presocratics were not burdened by the weight of philosophical discourse, but were somehow free in discovering the characteristics of the universe. That is also why the view of each Presocratic thinker shows us a unique perspective on life and physical reality. In 6th and 5th centuries BC, in the already very civilized area in Europe known as today's Greece, Turkey and Italy, there started something brand new. Few people were thinking about the world differently as people before them. What was new was the break with the already established dogmas about the universe based on myth and heroes. What was starting was the scientific way of looking at the universe. They were not anymore looking for the answers by turning to the gods, but by establishing arguments drawn from their observance of nature and reason. This is the turning point we usually perceive as a shift from mythos to logos. These people posed questions that were very basic and complex at the same time. The questions are metaphysical in their nature. What is the universe made of? What's the place of humanity within the universe? Can we trust appearances or do they deceive us? Is everything fixed and stable or is it flowing and changing? And that is how Western philosophy was born. We must understand that in those times, philosophy was not a particular branch of knowledge as it is today. Those were the times that being a philosopher meant dealing with questions about human life as well as nature. Their thought was a precursor to modern scientific thinking. Early Greek philosophy represents the beginning of philosophy in the Western culture. It is also known as the Presocratic philosophy. That is because its representatives lived before or at the same time as Socrates, the well-known Greek philosopher whom we mostly know by his famous saying, "I know that I know nothing." But let's leave Socrates for now. We divide Presocratic philosophers in distinct groups, mostly based on what their teaching was. We therefore have the Ionians, Eleatics, Pythagoreans and Pluralists. An important group are Sophists, which have a special status as they were mostly not philosophers but teachers of rhetorics. These philosophers lived in different parts of what was then known as the Greek world. Cities Clazomenae, Ephesus and Miletus were located in an area called Asia Minor, which is today Anatolia in Turkey. City Abdera was located in the north coast of Aegean Sea. And there were Greek colonies in the west, in today's Italy and Sicily, known as Graecia Magna. There were cities Acragas, Elea and Metapontum. First, let's clarify that Presocratics were thought by themselves as physikoi, that means the ones that deal with physis, the concept which we roughly translate as nature and more accurately as the principle that grows and develops and includes all things in the universe. Physis is opposed to nomos, a concept which means the law or a human convention. The early Greek philosophers saw the world as cosmos, an ordered natural arrangement that is inherently intelligible and not subject to any supernatural intervention. That is why they are also considered as the beginners of rational thought and also first empirical scientists, because their arguments are based on the observance of nature. They had very different views on the basic structure of nature. The one idea that is common to the most of them is the concept of arche. The word itself means origin, beginning, first principle and element, and is semantically also connected to ruling, as the word archon means ruler. An important precursor to Presocratic philosophy is Pherecydes of Cyrus, born 600 BC, who seems to be the first thinker who attempted a proto-cosmological interpretation of a creation myth. In his book Metaphysics, Aristotle states that Pherecydes blended the mythical with the non-mythical. In probably the first work in prose in Greek literature, Heptameichia, Pherecydes claimed that at the beginning of the cosmos, three primary, everlasting and self-creative principles existed. Zeus, Kronos, time, and Chthonia, the Ionic form of the feminine Chthonia, earth. The Ionians are Thales and Eximander and Eximenes, who were all from Miletus, Xenophanes of Colophon, and Heraclitus of Ephesus. Presocratic philosophy starts with the Milesian Thales in 585 BC, who introduced material monism as an explanation of the cosmos. Anaximander was the first who attempted to explain the origins both of animal species and the cosmos. Anaximenes was interested in cosmology and meteorology, and Xenophanes introduced a new kind of philosophical poetry compared to philosophers from Miletus who wrote in prose. The last one of the Ionian group, Heraclitus, was known as the Obscure One. He wrote a single book called On Nature in a very enigmatic language. The Pythagorean school started with Pythagoras, who was born on the island of Samos and traveled for many years in Egypt and the Orient. He migrated to South Italy around 532 BC and established his own school in Croton, which had both political and philosophical aims. Pythagoras is acknowledged as the important mathematician, but he was also the first who presumably used the word philosophia, love of wisdom, and called himself a philosophos. Pythagoreans brought a radical change to the explanation of the cosmos and the nature of a soul. They lived a very disciplined life of many rules and prohibitions. The group of Eleatics got its name by the colony of Elea in southern Italy. Parmenides of Elea is one of the most prominent pre-Socratic figures, especially favored by Plato and also later Platonists. He wrote a poem called On Nature, which is divided on the prologue, the way of truth, aletheia, and the way of opinion, doxa. In his poem, he aims to justify the unique and unconditional existence of being through the rational refutation of not being. Another Eleatic, Zeno, was thought by Aristotle the inventor of dialectic. He wrote a book in prose to support Parmenides' theory of changeless and unique being, and he did that through a collection of mathematical puzzles and paradoxes. He is famous for his logical antinomies. Melissus, the third important Eleatic philosopher, was from Samos. His arguments reflect Parmenides' line of reasoning in the way of truth, and he follows Parmenides' principles of thought, but not in every detail. The pluralists are in a way a response to the Eleatic doctrine. Their idea is that the cosmos is not determined by one corporeal or incorporeal substance, but rather through the synthesis of many powers and principles. The pluralists were Empedocles, Anaxagoras, and the atomists Leucippus and Democritus. Empedocles of Acragas was the first one to introduce the four elements of cosmos: water, fire, air, and earth, and thought the principles of the universe are love and strife. Anaxagoras was the first to teach in Athens and was interested in the cosmos generation, nature of human knowledge, and the structure of the physical universe. The atomists Leucippus and Democritus laid the foundations of atomic theory, a theory that everything comprises of indivisible and imperceptible units of matter, alongside the void. Now we have looked upon the basic doctrines of each pre-Socratic school, and let us turn to the way how we got to know this. The teachings of pre-Socratics are mostly preserved in fragments written on papyri. The evidence is thus extremely fragmentary and no complete work survived, even though most of the pre-Socratic thinkers wrote at least one book, that is, short pieces of prose writing or poems. We therefore depend on later historians, philosophers and compilers. Because of the fragmentary nature of evidence, new material occasionally comes to light. This happened in 1962 when there was discovered the so-called Derveni papyrus, containing material on Orphic religion which proved important to understanding pre-Socratic philosophy. Another example is the Strasbourg papyrus, which included lines of Empedocles' poem which we have never seen before. If you will ever stumble upon how to cite pre-Socratic philosophers, here is how. The referential book for the fragments of pre-Socratics is the German edition of Hermann Diels and Walter Kranz, abbreviated as DK. The edition with the title Die Fragmente der Vorsokratica contains original texts with German translations. Each thinker is assigned an identifying chapter number, for example Heraclitus is assigned number 22. Texts themselves are divided into sections A, B and C. A is so-called testimonia, reports from ancient authors about thinkers' life and thought, section B are direct quotations of thinkers, and C are imitations in later authors. When we cite the fragments, we use, for example, the notation DK22A19. This then stands for 22 as Heraclitus, A as testimonia, and 19 as number of testimonia. We have now gone through the introduction to the Presocratic philosophy. The journey in Presocratic philosophy which one undertakes is full of new discoveries, surprising opinions and piercing thoughts, full of mysterious sayings and unexpected conclusions.